Hi, I'm Nina from Pessler, and today I want to give you a quick introduction into our new app server that we will release with PRTG version 73. We've been hard at work at building a new API and a new web UI, which will give you a whole new way to access and manage PRTG. With PRTG version 21.4.73, we have released an alpha version for you to try out. Today I'm going to show you how to activate it, and we'll also show you some of its new features. Before we start, I want to make you aware of two things. This is an alpha version and it is not feature complete yet. There are a lot of things in PRTG that you can't do with it yet. Please also be aware that during this alpha phase, we might still make some changes to the existing endpoints based on feedback that we will receive from you. Now let me take a moment to tell you how to activate the new API and new UI. They are being run through a new service called PRTG Application Server. Once you activate the new API and UI, PRTG will start this new service automatically after reboot. You can then use both the classic and the new UI and API side by side. The new UI and API will be available under different ports. You can deactivate it anytime. Let me show you how this works. So first, I will log in. Then I will navigate to System Setup. And as you can see in the lower right corner, we have the option to activate new UI and new API alpha. I will click Activate. I will have to read through the disclaimer. I have to confirm that I read it. I'll press OK. And now we have to wait for the system to reboot. You're now ready to get started using the API. I'll show you how to get to the documentation first, and then I'll tell you a few things about the API from there. So we're logged into our new UI, and I will navigate to our API documentation on the bottom here using the card PRTG API version 2. I will click on try out and it will take me to our resource center of the API. This page answers a lot of questions. For example, our API follows the REST design principles, and you can also read all about how authentication works, what to expect from error codes, and an extensive section about the filtering functionality. We've provided PowerShell examples throughout to make it even easier for you to try it out yourself. A second documentation resource is the overview. So the documentation is where you can discover every single endpoint and what we currently offer. So what I will try first is a login. So I'll be on the authentication tab. I'll go to the post session and I'll say try it out. So I'll leave the parameters as they are and I'll click on execute. So now I scroll down to the response and I'll see I was successful. Also, you can see that you're successfully logged in because the lock sign here is now locked. What I can do now is a bunch of different stuff, but for example, I want to navigate to the devices tab. What you see here are all the currently offered endpoints related to devices. To start, I want to get a list of all the devices that are available. To do that, I'll simply go to the Get tab, leave the parameters as they are, go to the Try Out section, and I'll say Execute. So now if I scroll down, I have my response again. So now I also want to show you, if you click on Schema, you can see exactly what kind of values to expect from the server response. Below that, you can read all about the possible error codes and messages for this endpoint. Another feature I would like to show you is how to pause a device. I will use the pause devices by ID to pause a device. I'll click on the try out. I'll enter an ID that I have previously looked up and I'll say execute. I will have to wait for a few seconds And now I'll see that my response was successful because I get the code 204. So now I want to leave it up to you to discover the other endpoints and figure out how this applies to your specific use cases. As mentioned in the beginning, this is an alpha release and not yet feature complete, and a number of crucial features are still missing. As a rough outline, here are the main features that can be used already. You can see the status of probes, groups, devices, sensors, and channels. You can perform pause, resume, and scan actions on the above items. Features that we are currently working on are an API key, creating and editing objects, historic data, and more. The goal is to offer the full functionality of PRTG via this API. You can stay tuned for the missing features to be added over time via the normal PRTG releases. The PRTG release notes are the best way to keep informed about the progress of our API. Even if you probably can't cover all of your use cases with the API just yet, we wanted to let you know early on what's coming, and we would love to get your feedback. In case you need any technical support, you can either click on the support card in our new web UI, or you can open up a ticket with our technical support. They are always happy to help you. Another thing I want to mention at the end is that we are releasing this alpha in such an unfinished state right now because we want and need your feedback to decide on how to develop it further. To give us feedback, you can use the share your feedback card in your overview homepage, or what we will also do is release surveys. You can answer these surveys to help us decide on the next features we will develop. That is all for now, so have fun trying out our alpha features, and you can also find all necessary links in the video description. Have a great time testing and see you in our next update.